So now I'm going to show you how to add HTML style comments to our Lexer so that it gets the behavior that we want. Well, just as we had to list all of the tokens, we're going to have to list all of these possibilities for things we could be doing. Either we're breaking the input down into tokens, or we're handling comments. These two possible choices are called Lexer states, a word I really don't like because it's super ambiguous. We have states in finite state machines. Let's not have states elsewhere. This particular syntax for specifying them is arbitrary. It's just a function of the library we're using. So I'm going to declare a new state called HTML comment, and that's exclusive. If I'm in the middle of processing an HTML comment, I can't be doing anything else. I'm not going to be finding strings or words. So here's my rule for entering this special mode for HTML comments. If I see the beginning marker, left angle, bang, hyphen, hyphen, then I want to enter this special HTML comment state and not find words or strings or numbers or tags, but instead ignore everything. When I reach the end marker for an HTML comment, I want to jump back to the initial mode, whatever I was doing before, that time when I could find L angle slash and L angle and R angle. By default, that mode is called initial, all in capital letters. I'm actually going to do one other thing all at the same time. When we're in our special HTML comment mode, we won't use any of our other rules, even our super happy new line rule that's counting the line number. So what I'm going to do is call this string.count function to count the number of new line characters that occur in the token, in the entire comment, and add those to the current line number. This is a little tricky, so don't worry if this doesn't make sense the first time. Now, we've said what to do when an HTML comment begins, and we've said what to do when it ends, but any other character we see in this special HTML comment mode isn't going to match one of those two rules. Anything that doesn't match one of our rules counts as an error, and what I'm going to say is just skip over that single character in the input. It's part of the comment, I don't even want to see it. This is a lot like writing pass, except that it gathers up all of the text into one big value so that I can count the new lines later. Again, this is a pretty tricky maneuver. So now I've changed my web page so that it says hello. There's an HTML comment with the word comment in it, and then there's the word all. And if I've written all of this code correctly the first time, which really that does not happen in Lake Wobegon, then we'll get a chance to see how this plays out. There was an error. On line 22, this line number increment, it's yelling at me. Let's go back up to line 22. I had split these onto two lines so that it would be easier for you to see, but let's not do that because Python hates it. And now, with that one simple syntax error fixed, our web page produces exactly the two tokens we expect. Hello, starting at position 0, and all, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, all starting at position 23 on line 1. Excellent.